FrankPhillyTV back at it again. Of course, it's been a few months now that we have necessarily have seen, been on the fucking TV screen, so I'm back. Of course, this is ghetto motherfucker want to bring Sunkiss into the goddamn genre. Show him the Sunkiss. We ghetto five. Who gives a fuck? We got Sunkiss in here, orange soda. You know what I mean? We doing this a little different around this time, so we told you we gonna come with new fucking material. Let me take these glasses off. I know y'all sick of the shades.
You like
see my eyes. See somebody. These pretty ass eyes.
I don't know about all that, but, you know.
Fuck out of here. Mm. Now, we gonna jump into a real topic that's really about to get, I think that's very relevant in the black community, period. And we're gonna talk about pretty much, you know what I mean, women of today that can't really move on in their past relationships, or pretty much can't move on, period.
Yeah.
So it's pretty much now, it's like, you know what I mean, in the black community,
it's
if things don't work out,
it's just
well, not a black, well, you're right. Even not a black community, this is all around, you know what I mean, all races does this shit. But yeah. Bottom line is,
it's a women thing, not a black thing.
Well, a woman thing. Definitely a woman thing. But pretty much, ladies and gentlemen, we're in a situation where, though, a lot of people are not willing to accept their responsibilities when it comes to relationships that comes to fail or go down.
Or accept when it's over, right?
Well, accept when it's over.
Yeah.
And it basically comes down to, you know, a lot of bad things come out of it, whereas though, you know, you got people that use their children to get to the fathers, or fathers using shit to get to the women. Like, it's a real big fucking hot mess, but my whole ordeal with the situation is, if you have to acknowledge that it's over. That's one. And the second thing is how you're going to be able to deal with the children. Because at the end of the day, ultimately, it all boils down to the children that's going to have to suffer through this.
You gotta be able to accept that it's over.
Exactly. And at the end of the day, you know what I mean, like I said, in this generation, day and age, everybody don't like to, you know, establish in their minds that they had played a part into why the relationship didn't go the way that it did.
Right.
So a lot of the times, you know, they always point the finger, and of course, you know, there's never no closure.
Women never want to take accountability. They always blaming the man for the cause of the relationship ending. You know, they always gotta blame the man, and they use the kids as pawns to keep the man attached to them and to stop the man from leaving them and going into another relationship. So they use the children as pawns to keep themselves involved with that particular guy. You know, they do that a lot. They threaten you with child support and what else?
Threaten you, you know what I mean? Like, on the street level.
Oh, you're not gonna be able to see your children?
On a street level.
Right.
You know, like, well, I'm gonna get my boyfriend, I mean, my new boyfriend or my new, or my brothers or cousins to fuck you up.
Yeah.
All kinds of shit.
And then, you know, the one thing, guys, that you really gotta focus on, this to the men out there. You can't, you know, you gotta learn how to fight. You know what I mean? You gotta know how to fight, because if a girl get her dude to come and whoop your ass, you gotta be able to defend yourself. And you know, see him, he can't fight. You know what I'm saying? So he needs somebody like me to protect him. You feel what I'm saying? So you gotta make sure that you know how to protect yourself. You know, because things like that happen.
I'm not even gonna justify what the fuck he said, because at the end of the day, that's just his assumption. This is assumption. I'm not going to even get into that. But bottom line is, pretty much all in all, you got to be able to really be able to accept for what comes with it. You know, especially if you're married. A lot of times, you know, you're going through these divorces, and a lot of times it comes a lot with it. You got one, you got to make sure that the kids are established enough to get therapy. You gotta be able to accept.
Well, that's another thing. Talk about that. Some of the women will basically tell their kids that the father don't love them, or that your father's not a good man and he's leaving you for another woman. That's another thing. That's vicious. Like, how you gonna turn your kids against your baby daddy?
Because
that's
a lot
some
of
fucked up
but
shit.
You know what it is though. A lot of the times, what happens is that we all know and understand that a lot of women are angry at this point. They're confused.
Right.
A lot of times, you know, they think they have it all together. And a lot of times, you know, they get that misconception that, okay, because this is what happens a lot of times in a relationship. In the beginning, a lot of women think that, of course, when you get a man, you think that the whole thing is over. Like, it's never over. You always have to keep your appearance and
everything.
You
think the competition is over.
You know what I mean? Like, exactly.
I got him you know, he married, he mine now, we got kids, so he mine forever.
You know what I mean? You know, so that means I gotta go start dressing, I start going to look like a grandmom or some shit like that. You know what I mean? Wearing fucked up clothes and not pretty much look appealing to my man. But at the end of the day, besides the
point, they think they already got you, so it's over. Competition over, already got him. You know what I mean? So I don't have to do nothing now. He mine. So they think that the competition over, but somebody will take your man and do what you're not doing.
Very quick. Very quick. But all in all, the way it should be settled is, one, ladies and gentlemen, do not use the kids against each other.
Right.
Whatsoever. Do not use the kids. Because at the end of the day, eventually that will come back to bite you in the ass, where eventually the kids are going to start asking questions.
And I heard of many situations where women would take their children away from the father, and especially girls. It really affects the girls. Girls love their daddies. And if they're not able to be around their dad, naturally, right? Because daddies baby their girls, right? Mm-hmm. So a lot of times what happens is, if the girl's not able to see her father, or the kids in general is not able to see the dad, and they grow up and they find out that you, as the mother, stopped them and prevented them from seeing their father, they have a lot of resentment and anger towards you. I seen a Lifetime story about that, and it was really fucked up. And that happened in real life. So you think you're doing something to the man and hurting the man, but you're actually hurting yourself, because your kid's going to grow up hating you for keeping you away from the dad. So that's something to think about.
Exactly.
These glasses are really nice on me, by the way, guys. Like, I don't know why Dante wear things like this when I look better in it, you know?
Man, whatever, you know. Like, bottom line,
I know y'all want to see his beautiful eyes, though. So I'm going to just take them off and bless y'all with the eyes just for the day. You feel me? His cockiness is rubbing off on me, so, you know, it ain't my fault.
Yeah, as y'all can see, I kind of fell back a little bit, but,
you had to, you know, somebody like this just came into the scene, you know?
Yeah, thank God I told him to get that fucking cut. You know what I mean? Like, told him to get that cut, now he's feeling
himself. I'm just playing, guys.
But, all in all, everybody, let's just, come together as one and figure out, even if you can't be together, it doesn't mean you don't have to be cordial. It means, like, basically you come together, like, hey, I'm coming to get the kids this weekend. Do you need me to take them to their doctor's appointments, or do you need me to get the money? That's the way it should work. It shouldn't be a situation where
it bothers me that women do. Sometimes women, when they can't accept that the relationship is over, say, should I use you as an example or not? Well, whatever. I won't bring up him. I'll bring up somebody I know. Okay, somebody I know, where he left and moved on and got with another female. Oftentimes, it is a little easier for the men to move on. Men are not as emotionally attached. It don't mean that they don't love you, but it's just easier for them to move on to the next phase of their life. But oftentimes, what women would try to say is, they would try to say, this is really interesting. Women oftentimes would try to say, well, if it's hard for me to move on and it's easy for you to move on, that's because I loved you more and you didn't love me as much as I loved you.
Not true. It's never true, because at the end of the day, like, men are normally born built less emotional than the woman.
Right.
Because you ever heard the saying, I mean, the men are the stronger vessel and the women are the weaker vessel. So it's up to us to pretty much, you know, hold the strong will, whether we're in the household or not in the household.
What the shrimp got to do with the emotion?
Because at the end of the day,
they're stronger mentally and physically.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so you get it?
Yeah.
So it's
it took me a little while. You know, I'm LD, so I had to try to comprehend and catch up.
I wouldn't say that out loud. But,
I got to edit that out.
But, basically, it's almost like now, to the point where, as though, people just don't, they mentally, like, jacked up. They just don't really understand, like, the parts of, okay, this shit is over. Like, I'm done with you.
A lot of women had low self-esteem, and their life depended on the dude they with.
Yeah,
like they live through that dude. Yeah,
like they live through that. Like
it's without him, I can't live.
I'm gonna use me for example.
Or maybe they feel like they so ugly that if they lose him, they can't ever get a.
No, it's not even about that.
No. Seriously, some girls have low self esteem and they feel, well, I'm never going to be able to find nothing else again. You know what I mean? Especially if they got kids by you and they, you know, don't look that good. You know.
Or.
Not if you're with Dante, because if you with Dante, he's ugly. So you can easily go and find somebody else to be with, trust me, like me, that's equally as good looking, if not better. I just want to put that out there. Now he want to hide the glasses. I just gave him a little self-esteem.
Well, bottom line is, is that theory that he just explained, and then there's another theory where it's those, for instance, like if you made things more accessible for them. Like, you got up, you helped them, you got them back and forth to work. You always made sure the house
was clean.
You always did things enough, whereas though, it was everything was just pretty much enough easy for them.
Convenient for them,
where they came home and they barely did shit.
Yeah.
They just came in, kicked their fucking feet up. So at the end of the day, once they lose that, they're just as twice as mad because they know another nigga, a real nigga, he ain't doing that shit. Let her go to a real nigga and be like, oh, baby, can you go wash my clothes? And they gonna be like, bitch!
Right.
You mean wash my shit?
Right.
Cook my shit?
You the one,
suck
right?
my dick?
Right.
A lot of women, y'all, you know, I mean, they forget all the time that, you know, sorry, we dragging this video too fucking long. We're gonna bring it to a close like this. Ladies and gentlemen, it all comes down to, it's not about you anymore. Whenever you have these breakups, you gotta look at the kids ultimately. And I'm gonna take my glasses off on this one because I'm about to be real serious. You gotta take it in consideration of the children at this point, because at the end of the day, they suffer more.
Right.
At the end of the day, they suffer more because it's already a big divide between a black man and a black woman. But when it comes down to the children,
I got a drink on that one.
That when it comes down to young,
when it
comes down to young children nowadays. Mm-hmm. And you don't bring them up right, they're going to create the same mistakes that they seen mama and daddy do. And that's not what you want to do at this point in time. We want
to
treat
our... Watch out when you say that, because then they're going to try to flip it on you and say, well, what kind of example you setting for your sons leaving for...
I got an answer for that. Because at the end of the day, I'm not going to look... It don't make sense for me to be in a household where I'm not happy. And I'm the same thing I'm going to preach to my sons. It's not important for you to be somewhere where you're not comfortable at. And then on top of that, if you have children, you don't need your children seeing you or their mother going back and forth fighting like cats and dogs. Right. And they think that shit is okay to go do it to their girlfriends. Or they think it's okay for their daughters to be talked like shit to a nigga.
Yeah.
That's never okay. You know what I mean? Because at the end of the day, what you steal to a child sticks with a child. They're like, their minds are like sponges at that age.
Right.
So you gotta be able to change that, you know what I mean? Starting now. Wherever, you know what I mean, y'all broke up a month ago, 2 weeks ago, it starts now.
So, what advice would you give to women that are finding it hard to break up? What advice would you give them? How would you advise them to move on from a heartbreak relationship?
You have to get help.
From who?
Therapy. Therapy is really, and I'm not talking about going to a girlfriend or whatever, because that kind of get misleading. You got to be able to go to get professional help. Somebody that doesn't know you at all, right, don't know of the situation, because at the end of the day, you're not going to get no better strategic information from a person that you do already know. They know of the situation from a person that don't know you.
Because they're going to have a biased opinion.
Yeah, you know, bias and shit, and they're not going to pretty much, you know, I mean, tell you nothing right or nothing
funky.
Good or keep it funky with you.
You know?
Instead, I'd be like, listen, girl, you I ain't going to hold you. You had a good man. You let that man slip out underneath
your feet. And sometimes women don't want you to be with a man anyway because they don't got one. So they getting a kick out of your misery and a kick out of your breakup. Some women are like that. You know,
right,
they'll try to tell you to leave because they don't want you to have nobody anyway.
Correct.
And homies will try to tell their homies to leave a girl because they want to spend more time with them at the club fucking with bitches. So it's like, well, he leave her, then we can go to the club and fuck with bitches.
Yes.
You know what I mean? It's funner.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
It's no double standard in that point. I mean, both does it, men and women.
Yeah.
But bottom line is, my advice all in all is that, you know, make sure you get help firsthand, and then you work on getting you, if you want to do it individually or you want to do it as a group thing, you all sit down and have therapy with the children.
And realize that just because it didn't work with D or E or J don't mean that it's not going to work with the next guy. Somebody out there better for you. Always believe that if things
don't work. It's always love. It's no hard feelings.
It's enough love to pass
on. You always can throw the fishing rod into the damn water, man, and catch the next fish.
Catch another fish. The fish might not be big as me, you know, but you will find another fish, you know.
True. But in the meantime, y'all, we gonna bring this to a close, man. We gonna let me know what y'all feel about this circumstance, the situation. So in the meantime, this is Big Bro with your host Little Bro, man, and we checking out
co-host Little Bro.
And at the end of the day, man, we appreciate
the best co-host ever, by the way. Just had to put that out,
man,
there.
Fuck you, nigga. But at the same time, y'all, man, we happy to be back, you know what I mean, for the first time in months. So in the meantime, there's more to come. 2014 Frank Philly TV. Fuck you very much to those who's hating and to those who aren't hating. Love you.
Fuck you and your pussy.
Well, I'ma fuck they pussy. I'ma fuck they pussy up. I'ma tear that shit the fuck down. Why? Because I'm Big D.